I will lay out a few home truths by using my parliamentary privilege that guards me from charges of sedition and contempt for anything I say in this House. And Mr. Law Minister, sir, if you're present on the premises, with all due respect, this time you have neither the right to shut me up nor to try and get my words expunged from the record. The sacred cow that was the judiciary is no longer sacred. It stopped being sacred the day a sitting Chief Justice of this country was accused of sexual harassment, presided over his own trial, cleared himself, and then proceeded to accept a nomination to the upper house within 3 months of retirement, replete with Z-plus security cover. The judiciary stopped being sacred when it chose to squander the greatest opportunity that any bench of the highest court of this land has ever seen to reinforce the founding principles of our democratic republic and to uphold the rights enshrined in Part 3 of our Constitution.
One second, please move.
He cannot discuss.
Please,
in the House.
Wait.
And Nishikant is a point of order.
The minister is on his legs. Please, 1 second, please. Yes, Minister.
352.5. 352 point of order, 352.5.
Yes, yes. Premchandra ji, she cannot discuss.
352.5.
The Chief Justice, the conduct of the Chief Justice of India.
Let the Minister
here.
Let,
without giving the prior notice and approval of your chair.
Please, Honorable, please, Mahu Maitra ji, please be seated. Please be seated. This house is run by the rules and procedure. When a member seeks a point of order, definitely it is a right of the member. So I have to hear them and I will pass the order, pass the rulings, please.
352.5. A member while speaking shall not reflect upon the conduct of a person in high authority unless the discussion is based on a substantive motion drawn in proper items. Chief Justice of India ko hum log yahan discuss kar rahe hain, sir. Chief Justice of India, Bharat ke Rashtrapati ne us aadmi ko nominate kiya hai. Bharat ke Rashtrapati ke upar discussion kar rahe hain, sir. Aur yadi isi tarah se chalta raha to is democracy ka baaja bach jayega. Isiliye ki unhone Ram Mandir ka judgment.
See. Yes, I am. Yes. Yes, please. Please, Saugatraji, please. Please. Please, please, please. Saugatraji, please. Please, please.
Hey, please. Charban, sir, I'm a
Saugatraji ji, up.
Sir, that member is shouting. That member is shouting.
Please.
Sir.
Under what rule?
Honorable member, under 352.5.
Oh, please.
I'm going for an explanation. When the honorable member, Mahua Maitra, spoke, she did not, one, refer to any person by name. She did not mention anybody. And what? Hey, Meghwal ji, aap kuch nahi samajhte, baithiye. Number two, she referred to a person who was the Chief Justice. If that man would be Chief Justice now, no mention could be made against him, excepting by way of impeachment or excepting by a substantive motion. That man is a retired Chief Justice. He is not a man in high authority, and his name has not been mentioned. Not one word of what Mahua said should be expunged. I appeal to your good sense, sir, and your fair play and justice, that don't this lady be stifled by the minions of this ruling party.
Yes, Honorable Minister.
मैं ये कह रहा था, Chairman साहब, ये जो माननीय सदस्य बोल रही थी, इसने सेक्सुअल हरेसमेंट का आरोप लगाया चीफ जस्टिस ऑफ इंडिया पे, ये हमारे लिए शर्म की बात नहीं है और इस हाउस में हम डिस्कस कर रहे हैं और स्वागत राय जैसे आदमी इसको डिफेंड कर रहे हैं, ये इतने विद्वान आदमी इनको डिफेंड कर रहे हैं, ये तो शेमफुल एक्टिविटी है। आप चीफ जस्टिस ऑफ इंडिया पे सेक्सुअल हरेसमेंट का आरोप लगा रहे हैं ओपनली।
Mahu Maitra ji, please.
It is the misconduct of the member.
Let me pass the observation of the chair. We will go through the proceedings. If anything it is affecting the higher authority, and anything which is unparliamentary, definitely it will be looked into and it will be corrected. Please try to avoid such observations.
No, sir. Okay. Sir, it is extremely important that I not only not avoid, please, sir. It is very important that I not only not avoid them, but I bring them up, because I did not accuse the honorable gentleman of sexual harassment.
Please,
somebody else did. A trial happened which he presided over. Number one, let me put it on record. I did not. It is a matter of great shame that someone sitting in the Chief Justice of India's chair, to which he had been appointed by the President of India, was accused of such a horrible act. I did not do it.
Please.
Instead, let migrants walk to their
deaths.
She is
repeating the charges.
Let our greatest activists and modern freedom fighters rot in jail.
She is repeating the charges.
It now sits back as
she is not obeying the order. Chairman sir, she is not obeying the order. Chairman sir, she is not obeying the order. Again, she is repeating.
See, anything objectionable will not be there on the records. Please.
Sir,
yes. Obeying the order of the chair also.
No, anything.
She is again repeating the same charges against the Chief Justice of India.
Excuse me, sir.
Please, Mao Maitraji, please
excuse
be seated.
Excuse me, sir.
Please.
Sir, you are welcome. Sir, hi.
Mao Maitraji. Hello. You have already made your observation.
Yes, sir.
Please, let me continue with my speech. Please have the patience to hear the chair, please.
Yes, sir.
Please. See, the matter is, there is.
Let me continue my speech, sir.
Please, Mr. Chairman, sir.
Thank you.
Don't be so.
Instead.
What, madam?
The judiciary stopped being sacred when it chose to squander the greatest opportunity that any bench of the highest court of this land has ever seen.
Mao Maitraji, please. Please address to the chair. Please hear the chair. Please be seated. Please be seated for 1 second. See, the matter is
356. I'm calling 356.
Yes.
356. The speaker, after having called the attention of the house to the conduct of a member who persists in irrelevance or in tedious repetition, either in own arguments or the arguments used by other members in debate, may direct that member of discontinue the speech. Again she is repeating, sir.
Yes.
Aapke observation ke baad, again she is repeating.
Nishikant Dubey ji, wait. Nishikant Dubey ji, we have already disposed of the issue.
Yeah.
See, if anything objectionable to the higher authority regarding the Chief Justice, any allegation is there, please. Definitely the chair will go through. Please. The chair will go through the proceedings. If anything is objectionable, definitely it will be expunged. Yes, please continue and please don't repeat it.
Sir, the judiciary stopped being sacred when it chose to squander the greatest opportunity that any bench of the highest court of this land has ever seen to reinforce the founding principles of our democratic republic and to uphold the rights enshrined in Part 3 of our Constitution. Instead, it let migrants walk to their deaths. It let our greatest activists and modern fighters rot in jail. And it now sits back as a mute spectator when our young are prosecuted for cracking a joke. The judiciary seems to have forgotten the constitutional principle of separation of powers, that Parliament and Parliament alone can legislate. If something is bad in law, then the courts can strike it down or stay it on grounds of unconstitutionality. But unless it is so, the courts must do nothing. The government alone must face the consequences. If the government has brought in the farm laws which are not acceptable to people, then either the government will repeal the laws or the courts or the people will vote the government out. We urgently need the sagacity and courage shown by the high courts during the emergency when they delivered ADM Jabalpur and like decisions. The Supreme Court, unfortunately, is failing the common citizen and is being perceived as protecting the privilege and, ironically, only itself. A very large section of the Indian media has plummeted to new depths, both in terms of lack of factual reporting as well as the total absence of journalistic ethics. And yet, even when the bar is so low, the WhatsApp chat leaks detailing correspondence between a large government-leaning media channel and the head of the TV ratings agency expose the utter filth and the crony capitalism that, ironically, this government claimed to be saving us from. What is left of the resilient media is being targeted with the provisions of the UAPA and other draconian laws. You keep taunting the Congress about the emergency, But India today is in a state of undeclared emergency. But the government has miscalculated. There is a fundamental difference between cowardice and courage. The coward is brave only when armed with power and authority. The truly courageous can fight even when unarmed. Do not forget this. Do not forget this when you tell the authorities in Ghaziabad to clear the protest site overnight with the help of the police and the bureaucracy. You are not being courageous. You're a coward wielding power. The truly brave came in droves from villages wielding nothing but the belief that their cause is just.
Only one speaker?
One speaker. They were propelled by the spontaneous tears of their leader, not by the force of their water cannons. Do not forget this when you block the roads and cut the internet off in 17 of Haryana's districts. You are not being brave. You are a coward yielding power. The state of Haryana gives 10% of India's air force and contributes to 11% of the total strength of the Indian Navy. Its people can neither be termed anti-national, nor terrorists, nor gaddars. Do not forget this. When a peaceful 60-day movement is insidiously hijacked and then you slap FIRs on Punjab's farmers, you are not being courageous. You are a coward wielding power. Baghel Singh and Jassa Singh Ahluwalia, leading their missiles, captured Delhi way back in 1783 from the Mughals. Their descendants do not lead a lesson in courage from those who captured Delhi only in 2014. Tagore, in his poem, Bondi Beer, The Captive Warrior, an ode to Sardar Banda Singh Bahadur, wrote, Eshe sheshe ek din, jibon mrittu pai bhritto chitto bhavona heen, eshe sheshe ek din. That momentous day has arrived. In the 125th year of Subhash Chandra Bose's birth, the central government has made every attempt to hijack Netaji's legacy and weave it into their own fake, narrow narrative of courage. But this nation needs to know that Netaji had two clarion calls, both embodiments of his courage and his spirit. One was the salutation, Jai Hind. Today, this government has replaced this national greeting with a narrow religious chant that it uses as a war cry to heckle, to bully, and to always, always remind the minority about who's in charge. Netaji's second call was Dilli Chalo. Chalo Dilli. This government falls over itself to pay lip service to Netaji. But in truth, you block the borders in Singhu, in Ghazipur, in Tikri with walls and spikes for all those who actually want to come to Delhi to tell you that much like Subhash Chandra Bose, they too will not accept any halfway house. Netaji told us never to lose faith in the destiny of India, and it is not India's destiny to be ruled by cowards. The time has come for us
Please
all to
conclude.
Show courage.
Please conclude.
Girte hai sheh sawar maidan-e-jang mein, wo tifl kya gire jo ghutno ke bal chale? Repeal or nothing. Thank you.